our next presentation has a very interesting name. Won't you agree, Ketki?
Yes, indeed, Apoorv.
Okay, its name is Codzilla, the friendly autograder, and it is under the mentorship of Professor Avinash Aute.
So we are all used to being tested on programming courses through interpreting the results of the complex code written by the faculty or through multiple choices questions. Now, here is an opportunity to get evaluated on what we learn by writing programs. So can we please have them on stage?
I'm Monica Jain, and here are my team members, Prabhat Agarwal, Neha Sangeneria, Manvi Mukherjee, and we all have gathered here to present before you all Codzilla, the friendly program grader. There's a very famous saying by Steve Jobs that everyone should learn to program a computer because it teaches you how to think. So think, what can best assist you in learning to program? It's Codzilla. I'm pleased to present before you Codzilla, the friendly program grader, which is going to revolutionize the way of learning. Initially, we used to read by big fat books and long tutorials, but we could not follow because we could not practice along. But here, with Codzilla, you can practice all the questions from the basics to the very advanced levels. The roadmap of our presentation goes like this. First, we will see the demo so that we can get acquainted with the website. Then we'll see what is Codzilla, the different types of questions it provides. Then we'll see a walkthrough, features, learnings, and future scopes. Friends, the programmers of tomorrow are like the wizards of the future. You're going to look like you have magic powers, which is different from somebody else. So let's boost your powers by having a demo and by solving the question on Codzilla. I'll invite all of you to solve a question along with us.
So friends, here's a question for you. The question basically is, the user enters a sequence of ones and zeros, and whenever the user enters a number other than one and zero, the loop will terminate, and the sequence you get, the program has to calculate the sequence, the occurrence of this sequence 1010. Okay, so you can go through the question and help us in solving the question. Do you want me to read the question?
I think we got the question. Yes, here we have a program that is half completed.
You have to just complete the program.
So, anyone for the first blank? Please, zero, what should be?
The question is, the user is going to enter ones and zeros in a sequence, and whenever he enters a number other than one and zero, the loop will terminate. And the sequence you get, you have to calculate the occurrence of the sequence 1010 in it. So this is half written, you have to complete the program.
Yeah, basically preflen is the counts the length of the substring of the 1010 that you have got. Suppose you have not got anything, so it will be 0. You get 1, it will be 1. You get 10, it will be 2. You get 101, it will be 3. And if you get 1010, it will be 4. So that's why it has been written that way. So first we see if A, we have in the user, we have written A. If it's 0, we are switching over preflen. So now we have to fill what the should be the cases such that it prints the count, total count of ones, the sequence 1010 in the input sequence. So I'd like you to participate. That is what you have to update to complete the program.
But that will be one particular case or it's zero
in. There is the please. The there are more blanks. You wanted to zoom in.
Anyone for the first blank?
This easy. Okay, I fill this one for you. Because we have seen not seen our preflen is 0, we have seen a 0, so our sequence doesn't start with 0, so we don't do anything. So just 9 blanks, just 9 blanks.
Okay, okay, so now can you guess the next blank?
Preflen plus plus. Okay, we'll fill this one. We'll show you because you are not interested then. Anyone? Preflen zero break.
Correct.
Correct. Next.
The next blank, anyone?
Yeah, three. On the sound of it, two, na? Next.
Next blank.
No, this blank is left. We'll just show you now how we can solve. A0. Replane equals so now we can submit. Just dikhata hai. So here we get 100% correct. There were two test cases, both which we have got correct. So now we can, if we want to compile, we can compile, and we get the here compilation successful. Yes, sir. If there is another solution, it will be accepted because basically just compiling, executing their input cases. So this is a program. So yes, like we wrote preference equals to 2.
There is a multiple way of solving this.
Hmm.
Then you expect other person to solve it your way.
No. So because if you have to solve this way,
yeah.
Sometimes we need to understand other's code also. That's why this code has been given in incomplete form, so that you can understand what other wants to do and write. Just writing your own code doesn't let you, because half of the time we have to see others' code, then only we learn. That's why writing always our own code is not good. That's why this is an example where the teacher can present the student with half written code so that he can fill and understand and fill the rest part of the code.
There could be better ways of doing it. Right?
Hmm?
There could be still better ways of doing it.
So you can create question also that will be showing you just now. This is just a demo of show. So now we move to the presentation.
As we saw in the demo, Codezilla is the programming website where you can master any language from very basics to any advanced level. Here you can find questions to test your basic knowledge, like syntax, like declarations and all. And very complex questions can also be there here. And the uniqueness about Codezilla is basically you can convert any question which exists to this autograder format. That is the uniqueness. Any question which you have can be converted into a format which can be hosted on our website. Then also here you can create a question as well as solve a question. So at the same time you can act as a teacher, you can introduce questions, you can create questions in your private bank or public bank, and you can also solve the questions. So the different types of questions which are present on Codezilla are, there are total 6 types. First is the compile with no warning, then compile with no error, executing with return value, executing with standard output, executing with standard error, executing with standard input and output. Let's see the description of all these 6 types.
Okay, so the first type is compile with no warning. In such type of questions, basically we test whether you know how to declare different types of data types or not, and the code is just compiled on very high level warning. So your syntax has to be perfectly correct so that you get full marks. Otherwise, your score will be 0. Next type is compile with no error. Such type of questions are compiled, but they are not compiled with high level warning. So in such type of questions, warnings are allowed. So if even your program generates some warning, you will be getting correct score. The next type is executing with return value. In such type of questions, the teacher gives the students a piece of code to write. And basically in the question only, the teacher has to see whether the answer of the student is correct or not. And accordingly, he returns a value from his program, which is 0 for a correct answer and 1 for wrong. Now, the next 3 type of questions will be explained by Manvi.
This type is executing with standard output. Here, teacher will provide a code, or he will ask the student to write a piece of code, and student have to validate the provided code and should print the standard error stream, which will contain the error provided by the code. So here the teacher should provide the error in the output file, or he can provide as a text output.
there. So either one.
This six type executing with standard input and output file. Here teacher will himself provide the input cases and output test cases, and he can also specify the percentage marks for each of the test cases. Teacher can also specify the percentage marks for each of the test cases, and also the student can write a program or can write a piece of code, and then he will be able to test whether the test case, whether a particular test case is satisfied or not. This is the ER diagram. Basically, this shows the schema of our database. Here, most importantly, we have four tables like users, questions, submissions, and topics. Now, each of the user will create a question and has submissions. Now, each question will have question ID and will have many submissions. And each question will belong to several topics. Now these topic IDs will also be stored in the question table. So basically there is a relationship between each and every table so that we can join many tables and query out the results.
The various features of our website which are distinctly done are it covers all kind of question. As I told previously also, the uniqueness of Codzilla is basically any question can be converted to this Codzilla format. So the most significant feature is it covers all kinds of questions. Next, you can compile and run with custom inputs. You can provide your test cases and you can check it. Then there is the facility of partial grading. Depending upon how many test cases you pass, the partial grading is done. Also, you can view your submissions, and then you can create questions with the upload facility. You can also upload the files while creating questions. And also another distinct feature is the topic tree, which you will see in the walkthrough of the website.
Okay, now we have a walkthrough of our site. So we will create a question for you and show you how you can create a question on Codzilla.
So we'll be creating this question now. We can see like many times these questions are set in all programming online courses. But we have to give the options which give the users the chance to cheat and guess. But here we are asking him for a direct answer. Suppose like here, if anyone wants to guess the answer before I write it, and then we will show how we can create this question very easily using our autograder. Okay. So we can see this is the answer. Now we can submit. See, we got 100 marks. And if the user submits anything else, you got a wrong answer. Now we'll go to create question. Huh? Now this is how we can create a question on our site. So here first we select whether the question belongs to public or private, and then we select the topics from this topic tree.
Wrong answer.
Achha, oh, well, see, sir. Okay, sir. I think so. There's a bug. We'll see upon it. Huh?
Test your code with your
so here we'll show how we can create question. So which one? So we are selecting data types topic. Then we go next. Then we question details. Here we select whether which type of question we want. I am selecting executing with return value, and we can select the complexity because the score of the question depends what complexity you use. I am selecting easy, and let's choose a title. And here is a description which is optional. So we go next. Here is the creator's view where the teacher can write his question, and this is a student's view which what the student will see. Now I have a file which I'll use to write this. This is the code we just saw. So we can paste it here. Now, because we want this part to be visible to the student, we make it visible. And this is to be invisible. We don't want to see him that we have commented this. See, as we are doing it, this student section is being updated as we are doing this. So next we want to get the answer from the student, so we make this part invisible. We don't show him this part also. This part we make editable. Yes, sir.
Only the right view of the material. Only the right double quote bhi lena
hai. Se le rahe. This is how the student section now looks. This is what we saw now. So this is how we can create question using this tool. I can submit.
Okay, now show me why you are giving 100% correct. Can you show me the student section?
Student section. So this one.
Because we have hidden the rest of the code.
So that is what, when the teacher is creating the question. Then I'll zoom out. So this is so that he can see the both and decide like what is to be done.
He will get the right.
No, there is a user login, not student teacher login. Anybody can create question. Anybody can solve question.
No, that will stop. That's it.
This is what the student says.
One thing will stop. Anybody can create a question already. This right hand side is what the student sees.
And if I rightly can see the source, will I be able to?
No, sir. No, sir. We can show. Sir, so we now we submit this.
No, but that is interesting because that is one thing we considered. Okay, but if you are a student, say, who is smart enough to write slip and see the source and answer the question, probably you can answer it directly. You are smarter than that.
Sir, but there is no. Sir, we can see this. So this is what the student sees. Sir, there is no answer. There is only the part that is visible is only visible. All part has been removed. Because so now we'll show another type of question which will answer this time. Many times we see this convert to this kind of hexadecimal and to binary and decimal to hexadecimal, but then most of the times we get an option and again there is a guesswork. So here we can use this tool to very easily create. So we can we have made it visible and not editable 0x, so the student is bound to write a hexadecimal value. Oh,
anybody can guess the answer for the question? 63. Let's see if you are correct.
63. Wrong. Any more guesses?
Come on, it's a simple question.
Hexadecimal equivalent.
1008.
Decimal.
Decimal. Decimal. Decimal to hexadecimal.
Hmm? interesting. Just arcane.
36.
Let's
see.
Wrong.
Wrong. 64.
So basically it's for practice. So if we cheat, it's upon you. Again, wrong,
wrong answer.
Huh? 3A0.
Wrong. Wrong answer. Zero? Four?
Try
3F0. Okay.
It's the correct answer.
Wow. So now we can see my submissions also. This is how user can see what are your submissions. Anyone? And here is the all submissions. Here what all the people who have submitted the question for this question will be visible. Then, so this is the system server time. Server time. And then we have a leaderboard which shows all users and their ranks according to their scores. I have the highest rank. Because I have tested. So now we'll moving to presentation and this home page. This is our home page. So do visit our site and we'll now have a move back to presentation. As of now we have C, but it can be extended to all other languages. C++ is very easy. C++ we have, and it will be extending it to Java.
We will cover, we can cover any compilable language. Okay. Because we are using the compiler to test. Okay. Each question is a complete program. Okay. We just hide pieces of it and show pieces of it and then we compile. So any compilable language is okay, interpreter I don't want to even look at. Okay. We will start with about 400 questions at least in C, which I can guarantee. I am going to do that. Okay. These guys have created some 80-90, right?
Yes, sir.
All of Dr. Fatak's question will come there. Okay. Unless you have said it is copyright. Okay. In a better format. Not your, because for example, what I asked him to take, most of the questions were Dr. Fatak's questions, by the way. At 1008, the question that was given in EDX was some number, okay, what is the hexadecimal, octal and binary, okay, and then you gave four multiple choices. So, even if I solve one, I can do it. If I get the binary equivalent, I don't have to get the octal and this thing because only one of the four is correct. Okay. The same question now I can ask by saying for this decimal number, give me a binary equivalent, give me an octal equivalent, give me a hexadecimal equivalent. Instead of giving one mark for all three, I can give 1, 1, 1, 3 marks. So partial grading is possible. No, it will take it. You can give 0003F0 also. It will take it because at the back end, the way it is done is the integer I equal to which is hidden. Okay. So whatever you type, 0x is there. Whatever you type there, there is a semicolon which is hidden. Then if the compiler fails, you get 0. I don't care. Okay. No, you are not correct. Because you exceeded the integer limit. Okay, your program has to compile, right? Okay. So basically, whatever you write, the reason why we have given 0x is because you should not do that. Okay. everything that compiles. For anything which requires, most of the thing will be write a function. Okay. Most of the code will write a function. Almost all the program which I will create will have a correct function, which will be hidden because there is something called static in C. Okay. So you can't write call correct function and give me the answer. Okay, because it's static. All right. And it is after that.
Which compiler
do you have? All right. Most of the time, I do not want to use standard input, output. But about 10% of the cases will have standard input, output. Most of your whatever you are given in EDX, you keep writing, write this, write this, write this. And how many times this is written. I am not going to execute such programs at all. Okay. I'll just show it to the user. Okay. But internally it will be /////. So there is no point in executing. All I will do is get your answer and check. If it is 4, correct. If it is 4, it's like a multiple choice question. So I don't have to execute that. Okay. The advantage is I really do not want any output kind of thing. C in, C out, want to avoid, because all the questions that I create, I'll create only in C. All the questions are valid for C++, except instead of the standard, I have to do the other one. Okay. Java will come later, that is certain. Okay. They have put Python there. I don't know why, but I don't know whether I can do it. Okay. Whether the Python interpreter will allow me to take your input and tell me whether it is right or wrong. If it can, I can use it. Python is probably simpler because my question can be simpler because it can interpret only that. For C, I need to have a complete program to interpret. Okay. The most interesting thing they have not shown, okay, is that when you write a function, okay, before submission, I'll allow you to compile. Okay. So you can correct your syntax errors. Okay. Then we will also allow you to give input in some certain cases. If it is standard input, standard output, that is the provision they have made, okay, where you can say I will give input and then type in whatever you want to give standard input, and then you can test your program and find out what it produces.
Yes,
you can,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
I don't know if it works or not.
The test cases
are provided by the teacher when he is creating
okay,
the course.
Okay, that is only for the type
6.
Type 6 question. No, but even for 4 and 5 will
be. 4 and 5 will provide the output and error because there is
correct.
No input. For the 6th type, will provide the input output files, and then he can also set the weightage that he wants to give
for
each test
file. For each test file, you can have a weightage. Okay. For all those who went to the software quota, okay, software quota programming contest, okay, that is what I told them. They are nowhere there. They were working throughout the night. They couldn't get it. But my idea was that I should be able to do that complex contest using purely this. Okay. Yeah, because it has the specification based on that. It had a set of test files. Okay, each test file had marks. Okay, but the problem is that some of the tests were creating standard error also. Okay, so that's where there will be a failure. And most of the time, I did not have a output. The output code I gave them, this is the test file and this is a log. So, I created a log file. So, I may have to modify that a bit. But it can have any complex thing. Any programming can be done accordingly because it's so flexible. I can hide, no? I can hide, I can show you something, just edit this. Okay. I just written a while thing where you just give the while loop and give the while condition, that's all. Okay. Of course, I have done that. I have to do that all the time. Okay. And the interface is very, very nice.
We have timeout time.
We have a timeout of 2 minutes for each. And but the it's not like that we are monitoring the performance of an algorithm. I think we are talking about whether we are monitoring the performance of an algorithm.
How do I specify that? I have a new input. I need to test some No, it is not currently done.
The performance is not being tested right now. So just the basic is being tested. That is the future which we have. Next.
What if I try to insert malicious code?
Huh? What kind of malicious code you are talking about?
Oh, wait. Hey.
This
the answer is right now secret, okay, but we have taken care to see that not too much malicious things can be done, okay. So obviously you can't stop malicious code, okay, but to answer your correct question, the sandboxing has not been done, okay. It will be done. I asked them to look at it, they didn't have time, okay. It will be done, but currently we have taken care. You start doing that, it will probably say, will, what do you say?
Sir, most of the system commands are not allowed. You can't.
I said I secret. No, what do you say? Not allowed means what?
This is what we say.
This is what we say. Should not say that. You should not say that. You should say no, no, no. You are trying something very bad, so they don't know what you are checking. Otherwise, you will tell them what you are checking. Malicious people, you are not. For malicious entry, you don't have to say what you are stopping. Okay, just stop them. So they think you are great. That's why I didn't answer. Okay, we have taken some care.
Time out of 2 minutes. Sir, all this, it will show there is some server problem. Then you can try it again.
So, link is fail, you will get a timeout. No, you will not get timeout.
You won't get the response if the link fails.
So, how to get again?
You will have to submit again. Sir, the code is there, just you have to press submit. And because you have, there are my submissions, so the, if the link fails, the submission has been done. If the link fails after the submission has been done, you can always see that in the my submissions page. And you can then view submission what you have done.
Okay, so now you can see what our learnings are. Teamwork, quality code, deadlines, sleeplessness, and as we see the technical work, HTML, CSS, Bootstrap, JavaScript, jQuery, Java, JSPs and servlets.
What is the next plan?
Next plan I will tell you. No, there is no there next plan. It's my side. Okay. Next plan is to ask Dr. Fatak and Professor Suprakdeep, okay, to publish it on the EDX page. That is the next plan. By that time, I will get C++ and C up. So you can use. Students can use it for practice. Okay. The next plan is, that is why they had given a thing for public and private. Okay. The next plan is to actually support a private question bank. Okay. Because industry can also use it. Okay. To test their people. Now their prank has to be private, has to be owned by them. Okay. Similarly, for the quiz also, Eka Shiksha had given a provision for that. So similar, if you want to use it and the quiz module of Eka Shiksha where the time thing is there, that also can be put 5 questions single time. So once I have the private thing done, okay, we can extend it to actual faculty. Currently it is student centric. Okay. It's only for practice. And it will start basically with all kinds of basic stuff. Not your complicated stuff I'll take from you only. Exactly. You need simple things only, rather than looking at your code and trying to figure out what it does. For example, your complex code which you gave, which I got very irritated with, okay, I showed it to them, bad code karke. Okay. Set up the thing. Okay. It was a control loop in which they had given a switch. Okay. Inside the switch is modifying the control loop variable. And you're asking some n number of questions with 1 mark. I was so damn irritated. Okay. Now, in that kind of question, I will modify the question and tell, ask it, what is the value of the variable at each iteration? So, that's what your show was. Okay. First iteration, may this variable is this, second iteration, which case is done, which switch is done. Now, I can ask him to fill it up. Okay. You will ask him 1 mark question of what is the answer. Okay. Now, I can force him to execute each iteration. And ask him at when it reaches this point, what are the values of the variable? Fill it up.
I'll just tell.
I can grade him on that. How many answers he's got correct? I see it as an absolute limitless extension. Okay. And the reason why I kept saying this is the ultimate, because there's nothing else you can do here.
Excuse me, sir. That's the end of our presentation. Thank you for listening.
Please give a round of applause.
You have your fear, which might become reality. You have Godzilla, which is reality. I request everyone to register on the site and experience Godzilla. Thank you.